every single resident. Pay me what you owe me. Thank you, DJ.
Why did you guys allow a dictator to take office in Dalton, Illinois? Why did you do that? Let's check it out.
I do not handle anything as relates to with credit cards. As you heard me speak today in my board meeting about, I do not handle that.
Some of those charges are for you, though.
No, sir.
You didn't go to Las Vegas? What is that?
No comment.
You don't know if you were in Las Vegas?
Of course I do.
Were you?
It's not paid by them.
Did you fly first class to Las Vegas?
Any other questions?
Actually, yes. The credit card records do shed some light on tax dollars spent at several restaurants near the Strip, including Cafe Hollywood and Hot and Juicy Crawfish.
All right, any other questions?
So you're not going to answer how taxpayer dollars are being spent? That seems odd.
I just answered it. What do you mean? I just answered your questions.
You said you wouldn't answer about Las Vegas.
You asked me a question and I responded. So any other questions you may have?
Remove Tiffany Henyard as mayor of Dalton, Illinois. Why? Why do you think that is? Here goes, guys. Let's check it out. As residents of Dalton, we are deeply concerned about the actions and decisions made by Mayor Tiffany Henyard. It is with great disappointment that we call for her removal from office due to her misuse of public funds, extravagant expenses, and failure to prioritize the needs of our community. Guys, this is crazy. We're talking about a town of 20,000 people, roughly, with a median income of 21,000. And let's call Dalton Township a bedroom community of Chicago. These are the reasons why, and as we continue the video, I'm gonna go ahead and make sure I fill you in on every single aspect of this, guys, so stay tuned. Absolutely. Misuse of public funds. Numerous reports have highlighted instances where Mayor Henyard has spent excessive amounts on personal travel and expenses without clear justification or benefit to the community. There are so many times where she has, let's say, purchase billboards without authorization of the actual committee themselves. She's just writing checks, guys. That's what she's doing. She's not getting any secondary signatures or none of these things, guys. From the outside looking in, it looks like this mayor is absolutely pilfering from the community. Honestly, number three here seems to probably be the most egregious, and I'm gonna tell you why. Failure to prioritize community needs. Despite promises that she made during her own campaign, Mayor Henyard has failed to address critical issues affecting Dalton, such as crime rates, unemployment, infrastructure and education. If you've seen anything regarding this place, you'd instantly understand why the crime rates are not being adjusted. She's actually walking around with her own private security. Again, when I say dictator, I kind of mean that she seems to be acting like one. And the most ridiculous part of it, the reason why I say this is egregious, is crime rates could be fixed, most likely, if she didn't have her own personal security.
We really need them patrolling the streets.
So she's the part-time mayor of a south suburban village of a little more than 20,000 people.
Yet residents of Dalton are paying hundreds of thousands of dollars per year to provide security for their self-proclaimed super mayor.
Hey guys, this is Super Mayor Tiffany A. Henyard, the people's mayor and people's supervisor.
Don't nobody know nothing.
Here she is starting a Dalton Village board meeting dressed like the Wesley Snipes character in the movie New Jack City. And it's hard to turn anywhere in Dalton without seeing Henyard's picture or online, where she recently commemorated 9/11 with her own photo.
I just think she wants to be famous, or she thinks that she's bigger than she is. Her salary makes her the fifth highest paid mayor in the United States of America. But the only difference between number four and number six is number four is Houston. His salary is $236,000 a year, with a population of 2.34 million. Number six is Chicago. Salary, $216,000 with a population of 2.6 million. Her salary is $224,000 with a population of 20,000. She's making 10 times more money than the average median income of her constituents. And also, let's not forget about the time where she threw her city into a deficit of $5.3 million, then sent out tickets to everyone, if you parked or not, for $500 to be paid immediately. And if you were late by a day or so, $1,000.
Only on 2 tonight, outrage in a different South Suburban town, Dalton. Hundreds of people lined up to pay tickets they say they never should have gotten. As CBS 2's Jermon Terry explains, they were told to show up in court today or the fines would double.
Yeah, I sat down, I stood up.
I've been in line for 2 hours.
They are all here after getting slapped with various citations all of a sudden by the city.
At first I thought it was $50. And then I had to put my glasses on.
Elizabeth Watson quickly saw an extra zero for a total sum of $500. And if she didn't stand in this line to appear in court,
after the 21st, I'll be on $1,000.
The vast majority of people slapped with the $500 ticket say they never parked. This is not city property.
It's in a strip mall.
It's in a strip mall.
Yeah.
So are you left wondering why the city is giving out citations for a private property?
Yeah.
Mayor Tiffany Henyard did not respond when CBS 2 asked for an explanation.
This administration has cost us $5 million deficit. And now I believe that the mayor is trying to make up that deficit on the backs of the residents.
There's something strange going on.
So what is the tax rate in Dalton, Illinois? The minimum combined 2023 sales tax rate for Dalton, Illinois is 9.75. And then obviously the state of Illinois is going to take a percentage of that. Then the county is going to take a percentage. And then they're going to get a final sales tax of 0.75%. That's not actually terrible if we look at all the other towns in the United States of America. That's pretty average, I would say. They're actually making a solid amount of money, but they kind of need to learn how to kind of live within their means. I do think that with a regular, average, normal mayor, they could probably make that work, but unfortunately, we have the super mayor in Dalton, Illinois. The real estate values and property tax valuation in Dalton, Illinois. All right, so the city of Dalton has 7,674 properties, total value of $692 million. Average taxpayer is paying $4,523, which adds up to $32.3 million a year. Is there a real reason to double tax the citizens? To suck all the fun out of the room and make everything about one very specific person? Example being a car show that was supposed to happen, didn't happen. Why? Because the mayor was throwing a party on the same day and did not want the citizens to be split.
A South Suburban car show is canceled after the entrance is barricaded with giant concrete blocks.
Now, the sponsor of that show and the park district are calling it an act of revenge by the mayor in Dalton, Tiffany Henyard.
The park district is now considering a lawsuit against the mayor.
For the past 8 years, Darren Bosley has organized an annual car show here in the parking lot of Needles Park in Dalton. Bosley got an unexpected call last Wednesday from Dalton Mayor Tiffany Henyard's top assistant,
saying that the show would be shut down, but if I move my event to her location on Greenwood, that I would be fine.
Did you take that as a threat?
Yes.
Dalton police were threatening to tow any cars that parked there.
We're talking about two different governments. Talking about the park government versus the village government.
Dalton Park District President Cleo Jones says Mayor Henyard has no legal authority over park district property and believes she didn't want the competition to hurt attendance at her own event, a house music festival a few blocks away. Henyard is no stranger to controversy. Fox 32 recently reported how Henyard used village employees and funds to pay for a march to Springfield to support a charity in her name. What would you say to the mayor about this?
Get your life together. Get your act together. This is wrong for people that spend money with the park district to try to throw an event, a peaceful event, fine event, and it's good for the community, but you're taking that away from everybody.
Because it's not about her. What does it matter? Right? Come to my event, why would you go to his event? I'm having an event the same day, why would you do that? If it's not about her, it doesn't matter. The narcissism is absolutely real in this one here, guys. And it doesn't end, we're gonna keep going. There's just so much, guys. It doesn't end, and I mean this. I have no idea how she is still in office. I understand they tried to recall her and that failed. Again, there's so much corruption, guys. She's paying so many people. I'm not going to say she's paying people under the table, but that's kind of what it looks like outside looking in here, guys. I don't know. I think the worst thing you can possibly be is another elected official living in the same area, but you don't like her. If you don't like her and you're an elected official, bro, she's locking you out of your office. Where's my office? I don't know. It's not here anymore.
This was your office?
Yes.
What happened when you tried to open it?
It doesn't work.
The lock got changed.
Yes.
what appears she believes to be retaliation from Thornton Township Supervisor Tiffany Henyard. Now, both are elected positions, and the assessor says the supervisor has no legal standing to take any action over her office. Elston has been critical of Henyard's actions, including massive spending, as we reported last week, using Township and Village of Dalton employees to benefit a charitable fund that she created last year. You see, Henyard is also the Dalton mayor.
Yeah, I don't know how to get access to the building. Please go in this way.
She's please. The assessor. She invited us inside. Okay, this is her office.
Please stop this.
No, we're going to keep recording. Can you tell us who told you to kick us out of here?
This is my job.
The police here were called to the scene because we were in the assessor's office at the assessor's invitation. The police heard our story and said, yeah, she has every right to invite them into her office.
And it gets deeper. Of course she has an arrest record, guys. This makes all the sense in the world now, guys. What is this here? Did the city girl mayor, I believe it. Did the city girl mayor go from robbing cars to robbing FBA communities? To be honest, I think she did, guys. This is wild. Who did you guys elect? This is absolutely her. This is her name, her age. She was 33 in 2016. She got arrested in Chicago, apparently breaking into somebody's car. She bonded out. Oh my God. Criminal trespass to vehicles. Well, I guess that's that. I will 100% be following this story. It is so juicy. It kind of feels like a real life soap opera, but unfortunately there are real people who are being affected by this absolute tyrant. If you guys are new here, please like and subscribe. I'll catch you guys later. What?